Hi, how's it going? Today we're going to talk about couch potato games, or split screen, or cardboard splitting a TV, video game system, console stuff. Let's get started. Remember the good old days playing games as a wee one? Most of you watching probably know this nostalgia, assuming you're old enough to play the games like Street Fighter, X-Men Arcade, GoldenEye, Time Splitters, and Mario Kart. The delicacy of Mario Kart, indeed. Delightful. Such classic fun to get your anger out on the individual or the sibling next to you. Personally, I spent many nights with my friends playing Twisted Metal 2 or Nightfire with 007, yelling at each other for screen cheating and putting cardboard on the TV. Timmy, you're screen watching again. playing games together until our bladders burst, or being late to middle school while we were playing all night. Squinting was a main factor, and it drew you in. It took you really into the concept of split-screen video games. I squint quite often with my brother's 12-inch screen, trying to figure out what the characters are doing or who I'm shooting or if I'm even playing the video game itself. This is probably what the video game characters saw while I was playing it. I can't tell if that's a barrel or if that's a gun or a turtle. It was a no-brainer back in my day for video games to have split-screen. It was like a birthday party every time you got together. You got to see your old friends. You used to be able to slap them in the face with your dirty Cheeto hands. Then the beautiful day when online happened.
You've got mail.
Online games splurged on the scene like a teen looking at a nude photograph for the first time. Tribes was the first game I remember that had online play on the box. I was like, what is this amazing factor that I need to get my hands on? I can play with people around the world? No, it wasn't that simple. Back in the day, AOL and online took a little while, and you used to hear this amazing thing for at least an hour. Beautiful, isn't it? It's like Mozart wrote it. Nowadays, Fortnite, PlayerUnknown Battlegrounds, have online play with no bots. Don't get me wrong, online games are amazing. Graphics are astonishing, and it is quite remarkable you can talk to a friend in Australia and say, "How is it down under?" without a telephone. Or you can also say that line and then teabag them while you're saying it. You can't do that with couch or split screen games unless you wanna, if you're that close with your friend, I'm not sure your situation in that matter. N64 paved the way with Super Smash Bros., making the online buzz among many video games. It was out in the open that you could play video games and have competitions among players around the world, such as Quake as well. Early 2000s exploded with online games, making competitions rather than for the couch potato games. Even though you could go to a seminar or a competition event and play next to one another, online started to baffle many, and also AAA games started to take advantage of this beautiful invention. Graphics were a big factor on the downfall for the split-screen market, since the CPU couldn't handle all the beautiful graphics that were coming along. It was either the graphics or add in split screen. It was a double-edged sword, to say the least. You could play Chaos Theory with Todd while you lick their tears up from dying so many times while you teabag them. Or you can virtually do it, which isn't the same. You can't virtually kiss somebody's forehead across the country while you're doing online play. There's no factor. There's no birthday party. Yes, it's still fun. You can still cuss somebody's mother out, but it's not the same. The most popular online games nowadays are sports game and Super Smash Bros. Dang it, Favre. And also Rocket League. Rocket League is an amazing game, and split screen is sort of coming back, but it's not the same where every video game had split screen. With console games now able to engage in deathmatch and team matches with other players all across the world, split screen modes were no longer mandatory for video games that wanted to include a strong multiplayer experience. Issues of profit arose as well. If a console game had a 4-player split-screen mode, only 1 out of 4 players needed to buy the game disc, while a game with online multiplayer only focused every player to buy their own copy. Even the Halo franchise is a staple of split-screen. A staple of split-screen and console genre got both local, co-op, and multiplayer for its most recent game, Halo 5 Guardians. As the PlayStation Network and Xbox Marketplace and Wii Marketplace begin to gain traction, the way games are purchased and updated changes. Mobile gaming splurged on the market, creating a new easy way for this monster to have its feast of Stranger Things. PS4 released with improved internet capabilities for online gaming. At this point, PlayStation had the capability of sharing video games over the internet with friends. This is the PlayStation Share feature. Amazing, isn't it? Look at the sparkles. Isn't it cute? Sure, online-only games are great and amazing, they're not bad at all. Nowadays, every game is rushed, and none are bad. Check these ideas out. Cyberpunk, such a cute baby. It's an astonishing game, and the first one isn't better at all. They never learn their lesson. Dead Space, speaking of which of online play, was destroyed by online play and the designers itself. They wanted to build a video game based solely on action, and sort of like Fortnite, where everybody could play online. And it sort of destroyed the features of survival horror, basically. They could have done another route with Resident Evil type online play, but they did not, such as Resident Evil Outbreak, which was a very successful online play. Well, it wasn't very successful, to say the least, but it was a new experience that players never had the chance to play in a raccoon city where all the zombies attacked you and you get to play online for the first time with four players. There are still many great couch games that are coming back, such as Rocket League, Rayman Legends, Minecraft, Diablo 3, Cuphead, A Way Out, Overcooked, and Borderlands. It is heavily missed that couch games, or split-screen games, or cardboard games are mostly archaic nowadays, but they are making a slight comeback with indie titles. We could save the world with all the cardboard that we could use with our split screen. Well, thank you for watching. Thank you for all the new subscribers as well. Hey, how's it going? I have many more great content coming along, or hopefully great, to say the least. What is your favorite video game? What do you think of split screen? Do you wish it would come back? What was your favorite split screen video game in the past? Thank you and have a great day. Bye.